know who killed Raina. Any information that comes out about Ray Ray could lead back to Tariq.
Can't have our fingerprints on this shit.
That's a lot of bodies, man.
No loose ends.
One person knows the true extent of St. Patrick's guilt.
I'm handling it. What happened?
Look, Keisha, it's better that you don't know.
You know, I haven't been in here since.
Yeah, I know. You can't come in, and I can't leave.
The way we looked at it is that 501 is really 411, and everyone is implicated. Writing the first episode is difficult because the audience is coming in cold. We start the episode with Angela realizing that she's also implicated. And when she looks at the whole situation with a logical lawyer's mind, she realizes there's no way she's gonna get out of it.
You want me to bury the records? They never matched your gun. They may not trace any of us back to you. Or you.
The pivotal scene is with her and Tasha, where Tasha says, "Have you done it yet?"
Tasha, I'm very sorry about Raina and for what's happened to Tariq. If I do this, I'm doing it for them.
You'll be doing it for yourself.
And it's so great because it's an expression of those two characters. So we're shooting the funeral and we have to do the part where they're carrying out the casket. And that's coming out into the street and there are people there and you just hope that not everything ends up on the internet. You have to do coverage on all these little people. You know, Lala has coverage, Brandon Victor Dixon has coverage, Jerry Ferrara has coverage. You have to have all these little pieces to cut to. Tariq makes a bad choice. He gets involved where he shouldn't. He thinks he's a man. He's not a man. Will the audience be mad? Sure. But what would you do? He's already faced the ultimate consequence. He's at his sister's funeral. She's dead as a result of his actions, and he's still messing up. He doesn't have a beef with Dre. He doesn't understand. He doesn't think that Dre played him. Dre is a street guy. He's a killer. He's never going to be a non-formidable opponent. It was a very hard decision not to kill Dre at the top of this season. Very hard. We talked, we debated, because there was a version of this script where Dre was killed in that shootout. And then we thought about it and we thought, the story of how Dre becomes Ghost 2.0 needed to continue, and we also loved the opportunity for Kanan to save the day, to be a cowboy. I just love when Kanan is as big as he can get, is as huge in the screen as he can get. That's when the show is really at its best. I mean, you can't beat that.